Today, we're here live at Dr. Michael M. Krop Senior High School with the Director of Choral Studies, Dr. Gary Keating.
This year, I have 6 courses that I teach in 5 periods. So I have theory 2 and vocal technique 1 work together and happen in 1 period, followed by advanced placement music theory, followed by my advanced course. Then I have my women's course and my senior tech class, which are also combined. And then during the 6th period every day, I have my non-magnet general students course.
Okay. You have a pretty heavy load.
Busy. I first got to Michael Krop High School. There hadn't been a consistent choral teacher for 3 years. And so there was a lot of resistance and uncertainty among the students. Very much, I felt like they thought I wouldn't stay, that I would, that I would go away on them again. And so I struggled with the seniors that whole year. We did very well. We got straight superiors at state, and we got superiors, a superior, an excellent, and a good with a mixed course, a general course as well.
Okay.
But it was a tough year because they just felt abandoned. So giving them a sense of stability and helping them to look at new ways, I brought some new techniques, some new concepts that I needed them to buy into. It was one of the nice things about coming here, literally right out of my 3 years of graduate school, is that pretty much I was working with all of the new techniques from my vocal studies, from my course teachers, etc. And I wanted to share and build those into my program.
Okay. But there still is a glimmer in the big man's eyes. Did you have any special students when you first got here?
Yes, I really did.
Any one in particular?
I had a couple of special students.
Just one special one.
Yeah. And he's done very well for himself now that he's at FIU. But and some of them were really special. And I'm not sure that it was the inconsistency before I got here. Left here and really never used their musical abilities that first year. And that was very frustrating. But many of them that went through the program have progressed like you and have been very successful, and I'm very proud of them.
Wow, great to hear. Our second question.
You need to get out and hear other concerts and choirs. Once you leave college, the opportunity to continue to learn becomes more difficult. You have to really be motivated to seek out the concerts, the workshops, the conferences, and finances are a major issue, so you prioritize. For me, the American Choral Directors Association hosts its national conference every 2 years. That's a priority for me. And so I will be in Dallas this year, and I will see at least 25 or 30 choruses in concert.
Okay.
And then be able to hit workshops. And then on top of that, almost every publisher in the world will be at this conference. So I can be looking at the music for this coming year, the next year, the following year. And I find that more valuable to me than anything.
Okay.
And so then I go to the professional development workshops here in town, sponsored by the school system, and others that I can find. But that's really vital, and I also make sure I attend the Master Chorale, Seraphic Fire as often as I can get there, whatever it might be. New literature, watching technique, hearing, and you have to remember, the hard part about it is to remember that I want to hear and identify what's really good along with the things that I might not do.
Okay.
We tend to focus on, oh, that wasn't a good ending, or, ooh, that fell out of tune, or, ooh. You have to start to focus on what really is good so that you can see how that happened and then grow your program. yes, you recognize the things that weren't perfect, but I find I benefit more from focusing in on the things that I thought were really good and what I thought caused them to happen. Being able to bring those back to my choir, and it also keeps me way more positive in my rehearsal.
Okay.
My kids here, and even more so than when you were here, my program is not as diverse as it was when I first started here. And we've gone through a truly horrible time financially, and I've had to be here to try to be supportive, watching some of my students where they and their families have lost their home, lost their apartment, whatever it might be. So all of those things weigh in, and they have to be part of my teaching philosophy and my interaction with the students. So I have to approach each student and each year with a completely fresh mindset. And you have to teach what's in front of you, just like you have to conduct what's in front of you. Last year I had a mixed chorus of 64, a concert choir of 64, with five basses that all had low E flats that could be heard through the whole chorus. This year I don't have anybody with a really good F. So I can't do that music. So I have to readjust. I mean, I can have a plan, but that plan has to have flexibility. And then my other focus is on helping my kids grow and get into college or a two-year program, whatever it is that they want to do after here, way more than earning superiors at state.
Okay.
That, my program is not geared towards winning contests.
Okay.
My program is geared towards an educational process. It helps them grow musically and to make sure that I support the academics. I cannot not push those academics. They can be a great musician, but if they are a great musician with a 2.8, they're not going anywhere. They're not going anywhere. And that doesn't help them have the skills to be the good businessman, the good manager in their home, all those things that are going to lead to their total success as an adult. So for me, contests, I do it. It's not that I don't enjoy it, but it sure is not my focus. My focus is on an educated musician that's well-rounded, that's as strong a musician as they can be, but they have to have those academics as well.
Okay.
And then I count on college to take them the rest of the way. So if I've really grounded them, then they can go and be successful. I mean, I have a lot of students that come back to me and go, "Mr. Keating, nobody else can sing Do Re Mi. Nobody else can sing Do Re Mi in minor. Nobody else can." That's great. Now those college professors can take those kids to the next step, which is where they belong. If this is where your heart belongs, then you have to do it. I taught for 4 years, came to Florida to do my master's, decided to stay in Florida, and there were no teaching jobs. So I left teaching for more than 25 years, really. And then I started teaching part-time at Berry and FIU music appreciation classes. But my heart had always been teaching high school. And I think someday I would like to finish my career at a college level. But right now, this has been incredibly rewarding. It's what I wanted to do. It's been a tough time to be a public school teacher in Florida, but there's not one regret, not one regret. You have to get up in the morning and want to go do what you're going to do. And getting up at O'Dark 100 just to be in school has not been an issue any day.
Okay. Well, you've heard it from the Dr. Gary Keating. From here, from Dr. Michael M. Krop, School of Performing Arts. Thank you for watching, and have a great day. Music is what makes the world go round.